Hi guys, welcome to my channel. Today we will discuss about cofferdam and what is the purpose of providing cofferdam in ships or vessels. Okay, and see, these cofferdams are nothing, they are just void or empty spaces provided between two tanks in order to prevent mixing of two different fluids. Because what will happen that suppose in ships there are different types of fluids stored in different tanks in different areas, and if there is a leakage occurring in a bulkhead, the fluid will get up get into the other tank, which in result it will cause contamination of two different fluids, and thereby resulting in contamination and by causing huge failures and losses to ship owners. So these cofferdams are always provided in vessels or ships between two different tanks, and the intention of providing this cofferdam is to isolate two different fluids, or you can say to prevent mixing of two different fluids. And you all know there are different types of fluids and consumables used in ships, like lube oil, fresh water, BALA, seawater, sludge oil, oily bilge, like so many types of consumables are used in ships on board for major operations of the ships. So it is very necessary to take care and to prevent two different fluids from mixing always. So the main purpose of providing a cofferdam is to prevent mixing of two different fluids. Okay. So guys, you can have a look at this image wherein you can see the transverse section of a ship, and this is the port side and this is the starboard side, and you will also notice that there is a main engine fitted over here, and this is a tank top, and just in this tank top there is a main engine lube oil sump, and this is a port side, you will see a ship side, you can see a ship side tank, and the starboard side you will see the same. And here you can see a shaded portion which is the cofferdam, a portion which is being highlighted with cyan color, and the, these are provided on both port side and starboard side. And this cofferdam, the intention of providing this cofferdam is to isolate or prevent mixing up the fluid from this tank into the mixing of this main engine lube oil tank. Here, if there is a leakage in the bulkhead of this tank, what will happen that the fluid will get into this cofferdam, and even if there is a mixing in the bulkhead of this main engine lube oil tank, it will get get into this cofferdam. And what will happen that after going for sounding activities, in this cofferdams there are always two manholes provided diagonally opposite to each other, by going for a manual sounding or by inspection activities, you will come to know that if there is a leakage from different bulkheads or the partitions or tanks, then you can just pump it out from this cofferdam. So the main purpose of providing this cofferdam is to isolate the mixing of two different fluids from to prevent from mixing up two different fluids, because if lube oil and this fluid will get mixed, it will get contaminated, and which will result in huge loss and in operation points of vessel also. So this is the main intention of providing cofferdam in vessels or ships, and these cofferdams will be provided in between different tanks, like in order to suppose if there is a ballast water tank and if there is a fresh water tank. So in ballast tank obviously there will be seawater, and fresh water tank obviously there will be fresh water. So this fresh water and ballast water should never get mixed up. So in between these two tanks also you will notice the cofferdam, and likewise in different areas between two different partitions of tank, you will notice these cofferdams or void spaces or empty spaces. Okay, and let's see, we all know that ship carries different consumables or fluids, like fuel oil, lube oil, fresh water, bilge water, sludgy, oily bits, like so many consumable which on board for the major operations of the vessels. So see, this intention is to take care always that the two different fluids should never get mixed up. So the main purpose for providing this cofferdam is to prevent mixing up two different fluids. Okay, and if you see, a ship operates using four main kinds of liquids throughout its system, like fuel oil or diesel oil, lube oil, fresh water and sea water. And these consumables are stored at various places on the ship in their dedicated tanks. And apart from this, you will also note there are other liquids such as oily bits and sludge are also generated on board from the working of machineries, which will in turn lead to so many leakages, and these leakages will be always stored in cofferdams, and it can be pumped out whenever necessary by going for inspection and manual sounding process. Okay, so usually several numbers of tanks are provided on board ships to store different kinds of fluids which are used on board or generated for normal operation of marine engine and auxiliary machines. And the functions and properties of all these liquids, fluids or consumables are different, and they are stored separately, and care must always be taken in order to prevent them from getting mixed. Okay, so the intention is to isolate these two different fluids. Okay, suppose if there is a leakage or failure in the bulkhead or boundary of the tank separating them, then this because of this leakage, the fluid which is getting leaked through the bulkhead will get stored in the cofferdam, and we can pump it out from the cofferdam by doing a manual sounding process, wherein we will come to know the if there is a leakage identification. Okay, and to overcome the mixing of two different fluids, a void or empty space compartment is provided between the tanks to prevent two different liquids from mixing with each other. So this space is known as cofferdam, and this avoids intermixing of two different liquids when there is a leakage from the boundary separating two different liquids. And you may find the cofferdam provided in different situations and between two between different tanks. Okay, these cofferdams are provided with manuals for entry and inspection, and it is also provided with sounding pipe to check leakage from any of the subordinate tanks. Okay, and it's always maintained dry to leak and early to detect an early leak. Okay friends, and you will also see these cofferdams provided between fuel oil tanks, lube oil tanks, fresh water tanks, in the engine room also, because in engine room because there will be a lot of leakages, and these leakages will be stored in the fuels, liquids or consumable, whatever which is getting leaked in the engine room or machinery space will be stored in the cofferdam, and it can be pumped out as and when it's necessary. Okay, and you will find the application of these cofferdams around main engine lube oil drain or some tank to separate it from the double bottom tank, or between two different grade liquid tanks like diesel oil and fuel oil service tanks also. So friends, this is what the application of this cofferdam is all about, and the criticality of the cofferdam depends upon the ship owners and ship manufacturers aspects. So guys, you can have a look at this picture also. This is also a cofferdam provided in a vessel, wherein you see this is the bulkhead, and this is also bulkhead, and here you will see the manuals provided on the bulkhead to access the access that tank, and here you will see the access hole for accessing this cofferdam. And this is also a picture showing cofferdam in a vessel or a ship, and this is the bulkhead, and this is also a bulkhead, and here there is a pipeline going, and on the bulkhead you can see a manhole provided to access the tank on the other side. Okay, and this is the access hole for accessing these cofferdams. And in cofferdams always there are manholes provided to access the cofferdam and to do the ease of inspection activities. And manual sounding pipes will also be provided, so that if there is a leakage, and you come to know that if there is a leakage from a bulkhead, then by going for this manual sounding process, I can identify the leak, and the leaked fuel which is being stored in the cofferdam can be pumped out. So guys, this is what a cofferdam is all about, and there are different types of cofferdams, and it will be provided between different types of between the partition between two different tanks, and the main intention is just to collect the leakage from two different tanks and it will be stored in the cofferdam, and we can pump it out whenever necessary. So cofferdams are nothing, just void empty spaces provided between two different tanks just to isolate two different fluids or to prevent two different fluids from mixing. So guys, this is what a cofferdam is all about. Hope you all might have enjoyed this video session, and if you find it informative, I would request you all to like, share and subscribe my channel, and you can drop your comments as and when applicable. I'll be always happy to assist you. Thank you so much for listening to my video.